You are the first person, Bob.
Good evening.
Yeah.
Good evening.
Good evening.
Good evening.
Good evening. Now everyone's taking their seats. Good evening.
Good evening.
I request all of you to turn off your mobile phones or keep it on silent. May the guests please introduce themselves.
Good evening. My name is Srikant. I'm from MCA. My branch is MCA and I'm from MBA College.
Hi, I'm Rajiv. I'm Apu's friend. Going through my holidays now. I'll get a seat in the corner soon. I just finished my second year.
Okay. So I'm Achu. I'm Apu's brother. I just finished my 5 year at Canfield Engineering.
For any Batman fan out here, this quote might seem a bit familiar. The night is darkest just before the dawn. Most of us give up the moment we meet with any resistance, any struggle, any problem in our life. Or we just shout out to someone else. Whereas, if we look at history, we see the people who are successful are the ones who have actually faced these challenges head on, have taken it up, and who have overcome these challenges. I have a small story I'd like to share with all of you today, which I read when I was a kid, and I think it's kind of suitable for this. There was a small boy who was running around the playground playing. And one day when he was playing as usual, he saw this beautiful cactus flower nearby. He was so enthralled by it that he picked it up and got it home to show his mom. Upon showing his mom was also fascinated by it. He pleaded with her to let him keep it as a pet. She agreed with him, telling him that okay, you can keep it, but you have to promise me you'll take care of it properly. He happily agreed. Then she got him a jar in which he kept the caterpillar. He got a lot of leaves and branches for it. And daily he would wash the caterpillar, see it grow, see it eat, get a new leaves to eat, get a few more twigs. And as the days grew by, it started becoming fatter and fatter. Then one fine day, he noticed it climbed up a twig and started acting a bit funnily. He was worried. He didn't know what happened. He was just a kid. So immediately he ran to his mom and told him, the caterpillar is acting seriously, I don't know what's happened. His mom came to the area and she realized that caterpillar was actually forming a cocoon. And she just told the kid, don't worry, it's just forming a cocoon. When it breaks out, it becomes a beautiful butterfly. He was fascinated. And daily he would come, sit and stare at the jar for hours on end, hoping that a butterfly would emerge. After a while, one day when he sat down, looking at the cocoon, he noticed a small hole in the bottom of the cocoon. And slowly he saw a butterfly emerge from that hole. He saw struggle and struggle as it was coming out. And he was just observing it fascinated for a while. And he just kept struggling and struggling. Then after a while he got worried. The butterfly wasn't coming out. It was just stuck inside. And he didn't know what to do. He couldn't find his mom anywhere. So being a child, he thought he'd help the butterfly. He ran to the kitchen and got a scissor with him. When he came back, he slowly opened the cocoon with it, being careful not to hurt the butterfly. The butterfly escaped from life. After opening the cocoon, the butterfly emerged. And it looked beautiful. However, he noticed it was a bit swollen up and the wings were slightly small. He was waiting for it to spread his wings and fly and sat there for a while. And he noticed the butterfly was just standing there or walking around. I didn't even flap his wings. He got worried. He tried moving the jar to make it fly. It didn't fly. It just didn't fly. It's just staying there. He ran to his mom, cried and told her there's something wrong with the butterfly. It's not flying. His mom rushed to the jar. And when she noticed what happened, she asked her son, "Will you open the cocoon?" He's like, "Yeah, the butterfly was struggling. I felt worried, so I opened it." And then she told him, "My dear child, the butterfly has to struggle out of the cocoon. This struggle of the butterfly out by as it emerges from the cocoon strengthens its wings. And only after this is its wings strong enough to allow it to fly. By opening the cocoon early, it wasn't able to fully develop its wings. And because of that, it was destined to be on the ground." And the boy, in his good heart, had actually ended up harming the butterfly. I think what we can learn from the story is that as we go through school and life, we face many challenges, and it's a struggle that brings out the best of us. It's a struggle that helps us succeed. We can go as far as saying, it's a struggle that causes you to develop the ability to fly. One great example of such a person is sitting right here with us today. Even as a child, he was mocked for his poor grades in maths, but instead, like most of us would have done, he would just be demoralized and stop studying altogether. Instead, he took this as a challenge. He took it upon himself to work harder instead. He ended up topping the class in the 10 boards. He has the courage to follow his heart and has decided to become an entrepreneur. Overcoming various hurdles along the way, he started his own venture, Clean Power Call, in an aim to provide clean, sustainable energy to the masses. His other achievements also include setting up a 1.8 kilowatt permanent magnet DC small wind turbine, which he made using renewable materials. This was inaugurated by none other than Dr. Veerappa Modi, the Union Minister of Law in the Government of India. It's my great pleasure to introduce such a person here today. Mr. Diwakar, can you please take the stage?